fast food online ordering system. The project is developed under object-oriented programming. So the very first thing that I've used in my project is include iostream header file. This header file is used for the support of input and output functions that have been used in the program. Then using namespace std, this contains all the standard names that have been used in the program. Then this is object-oriented programming, so a class is created. Class name is fastfood. Then I have used access specifier. Access specifier is public because I want to access these variables outside the class, not only within the class. Then I have used a member function, that is void get. This is void means empty because it is not of any type, it is of void because it is not returning any value. So the code written here will be printed because I have used a void get to get all the code that I have printed here. I have written here. There are some more integers or I can say sorry variables that have introduced like a string name, int, order number. Then I have used a cin function. You can see cin name. This is an input function, and cout these are our output functions. The operator that have been used after cin function is cin standard operator, and the use that is after use after cout function, it is output standard operator. Then after this is I have developed this program on if else statement and switch statement. Let me show you further. So it is if, then inside the if statement I have used a condition order number equals to 1. I have used here equals to, this does not mean order number equals to 1, no. If the order number, the value of order number is exact 1, if a user inputs 1, then it will show the code block that have been written in the if statement. After this, I have again used the nested, here I have used nested if else statement, if inside if. So here's another code written in the if statement. Then I have used switch statement, and inside the switch statement I have put a variable or variable size, and then I have here declared some cases that if case 1, if user enters case 1, you have to print out this. If user enters case 2, you have to print out this. And after every case I have used break statement. Break statements, what does this do? If I do not use break statement, the code means our console will show the all three statements, but break statements break the one statement and then inputs then shows the statement of an other case. So here I have used break statement for this. You can see whole program is developed under if else and switch statements, if else if and switch statements, and I have given condition code, and it shows the code that have been written in all the statements. Then in the last I have showed else, please select right option. Means if the option is not that I have mentioned that it should be from 1 to 3 or it should be from 1 to 5. If user enters 10 or 11, that it will ask user that please enter the right options. Then after I have used here the int main. I have created object of class. We create object of class to access the class. If I do not create object, my code will not work. It will not show output. So I have created here fast food orders. Orders is the object of fast food class, and then I have called orders.get. Orders.get, the dot operator is used to access the functions of the class. So here I have used orders to get, means I have to get the function that I have defined in the class. So here I have used this, I have created object and then called that function through object. In this way I will get all the code that have been in the I have mentioned in the classes. So this is how it shows output. Welcome to Fizzaz Fast Food. Please enter your name. First you have to enter any name. Suppose I'm entering any name, and then press enter. As you press enter, it moves to further. It shows you hello. It says hello FF, what would you like to order? Then it shows menu. Now for suppose I have to order pizza, so I write please enter your choice 1. Then again press enter. It further give you choices that which kind of pizza you want: chicken fajita, chicken BBQ, peri peri or creamy mix. So you have to enter which flavor would you like to have. So I would like to have flavor number one, that is chicken fajita. Then it says please two size. You want small size regular pizza or a large size pizza? I'm ordering a small size pizza. So one. Again, it asks you to enter quantity. How much you want? So I want two small size pizza. Okay. So this is how final result it shows your order to fajita pizza. Your total bill 500. So it calculates the quantity, price, and quantity. It gives you total result. This quantity means if you have asked two pizza, three.